गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड अबाउट द टेबल ऑफ लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी. वी नो द मीनिंग नाउ, डेफिनेशन एंड टेबल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द ग्राफ, हाउ टू ड्रॉ द ग्राफ ऑफ लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी. सो यू कैन सी द टेबल. सो रफली इफ यू ड्रॉ द शेप ऑफ If we roughly draw the shape of law of diminishing marginal utility will be somewhat like this. So let us take the table and draw the graph with the measurement. So here we are making three division, that is unit, nothing but we can tell it as a commodity. We can name it as a commodity also. So now we having the commodity, total utility and marginal utility. By using these three things we have to draw the graph. So graph, how to draw the graph? So we have to take the consideration of the OX axis and OY axis. First we will go with OX axis. OX axis, it represent the quantity of the commodity. Quantity of the commodity means the number of commodity, how many commodity we are consuming. You can see here we are consuming six commodities, total six commodities. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 our total commodities are six. Okay, so next we are going with the OY axis. The OY axis, it represent the utility. This is represent by the utility. In utility, it represent both the total utility and marginal utility is represent in OY axis. So OY axis represent the utility, both total utility and marginal utility. So now let us take the graph. So first we will start with the marginal utility because it's easy to draw. So marginal utility, when you are consuming the first commodity, the marginal utility is 12. So here when you are consuming the first commodity, your marginal utility is 12. It is greater than 10. Here if we take the measurement, here it will be 10, just little up to that, it will be 12. When you are consuming the first commodity, the marginal utility is 12. When you are consuming the second commodity, the marginal utility is 6. When you are consuming the second commodity, the marginal utility is 6. And when you are consuming the third commodity, the marginal utility is 4. Third commodity, marginal utility is 4. You can see clearly here, 6 means greater than 5, 4 means lesser than 5. Next, when you are consuming fourth commodity, the utility is 2. When you are consuming fourth commodity, the utility is 2. When you are consuming first commodity, the utility is 12. Second commodity, the utility is 6. Third commodity, the utility is 4. Fourth commodity, the utility is 2. What happens when it comes to fifth commodity? The marginal utility is 0. So 0 means that should be located on the axis, OX axis. It will come above the OX axis. After that, what happened? The utility is continue declining. It will become negative. Negative means minus 2. It will come below the OX axis. That is this point. This will be minus 2. Next to that, what happens? Now we are going through with the total utility. Now we are going to measure total utility. So total utility, how you are measuring? You have to goes on adding marginal utility. When you continuously goes on adding marginal utility, you will get the total utility. So when it comes to first commodity, there will be no other commodities are available. So the total utility will be the same as marginal utility. The total utility is same as the marginal utility. So when you are consuming the first commodity, the total utility will be continued. So you can see here, when you are consuming first commodity, the utility will be 12. When you are consuming the second commodity, the total utility will be 18. When you are consuming third commodity, the total utility will be 22. When you are consuming the fourth commodity, the total utility will be 24. This is 24. And when you are consuming the fifth commodity, the utility will remain same. It also the 24. So you can see here a straight line. Why it is a straight line? Because in the both the places the utility is same. But when it comes to sixth commodity, the utility will start to decline from 24 to, it will start to decline to the sixth. The utility will start to decline. And that is about this graph. So now you have to explain the things which are there in the graph. So I hope you understood. First you have to start with the y axis, you have to draw the oy axis, then you have to go for the draw of, first you have to draw the ox axis, then you have to go for to draw oy axis, then you have to locate the point. So here, after another important concept, you have to write the measurement. What is the measurement over here? So we can say ox is equal to 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit. That only OY axis, how much difference is there? 1 centimeter is equal to 5 units. So you can take 5 units notes. I think in the notes you have taken as a 2 units. It is up to you. You can take any measurement. So now let us go through the explanation of the graph. So what does it explain? So first, OX axis measures the quantity of the commodity. So here it measures the quantity of the commodity or units, which is measured in the OX axis. OY axis measure utility, that is total utility and marginal utility. TU means, here we have written TU, and the same time you also have to mention what is this total utility, marginal utility. Here they have mentioned. So what is that? Total utility means TU and the marginal utility means MU. Total utility is increasing but at a diminishing rate. So you can see the total utility is increasing, but the differences between these numbers is less. It is increasing in a lesser number. The number is not the numbers are continuously not increasing. It is increasing at a diminishing rate. So marginal utility is diminishing with increase in the consumption of commodity. So marginal utility, you can see here, it is goes on reducing, but what? At a decreasing rate. So next, we can conclude that when the commodity, the number of the commodity increases, the utility which is derived from the particular commodities, it is goes on reducing. So the, you can see the relationship. When total utility increases or rises, the marginal utility is diminishes. When total utility is increasing, marginal utility is decreasing. When total utility is a maximum, that time the marginal utility is zero. When it is 24 is maximum, it is zero. When total utility is diminishes, the marginal utility become negative. When it is start to reduce, this will be negative. This is the relationship between total utility and marginal utility. So when you are drawing the graph, first you have to draw the OX axis and OY axis, then you have to locate the point and you have to write the measurement. By using the table, you have to locate the point on the total utility and marginal utility by using the table. So you have to use the table and you have to look at the point at total utility and marginal utility. I hope you understood the law of diminishing marginal utility. To take your notes, go through that and study it. Thank you.